Good afternoon. How do you do? Well, when I got an invite, so it was mainly I was told to speak about power, energy, renewable, and about me, my introduction. So I felt basically power, energy, renewable, we'll come to that because there's enough material on your, just Google it, you'll find it. It will be more interesting if I can share with you my academics to professional journey. It's a roller coaster, and if I can share with you some of the learnings or experience which can inspire you, motivate you, and help you in any of your future career, so that would be my one of the, basically I'll feel it satisfying. My talk is satisfying. So your institute basically has been very, very close to me from heart, right from the childhood. Now, what has been the reason? If I go back, my childhood days, we were at one small township, public sector colony, eastern part of the country, and 2,000 families. So 70s, 80s, the life used to be that each of the family was limited to the activities of the other family. There was black and white TV days and Doordarshan and nothing else. So that kind of environment, public sector, if anybody was staying, that people will be more connected, and they are looking at what their son is doing, what their daughter is doing. So two of the your alumni, they have been very close to our family. They were our family friends, relatives, and one was 10 years senior to me, other was 5 years. And they both got admission in Thapar Institute of Engineering. And I, being an average student, my mother used to scold me most of the time. Roj daant padti thi ki usko dekho, usko dekho, uska engineering mein admission ho gaya, tum padte nahi ho. So that's how it has been a very, very close, this Thapar Institute is to my heart. Ki bahut 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 daant khilwai hai isne mujhe bachpan mein. And so I, when I invite came, so I felt happy that yes, I went back to my memory lane and recollected those things. Now, as I told you, I have been an average student. So what I want to share with you, that once you decide a career by design, what kind of challenges you come across and how you convert those challenges into opportunities, that's the little journey I would like to share. Us colony mein, township mein kya hota tha? Ek hi objective hota tha parents ka, engineer bano ya doctor bano, baki kisi ka kuch pata nahi tha. Aur ab that kind of environment was somehow I was not liking, and most of the families during summer vacations, they used to go to hometown, and my hometown was Delhi, and I was too attracted about Delhi, metros and other things. So how can I go to Delhi? How can I reach Delhi? So there was only option that get into engineering, come out of this township, take a hostel life near Delhi, and that's the only way. Otherwise, you will be put into the BSc and all those courses in the local university. And 11th and 12th, I studied hard, worked hard, and luckily got into the competitive exam, and there used to be RECs that time, combined exam for RECs nowadays, NITs, so good. Now all the RECs are available, my finger is on the Jaipur, which is close to Delhi. Okay, and I got admission in Jaipur. Now, couple of years went well, did well, then I thought that public sector life, that life where I was staying, where my parents have been always saying engineering karo aur yahan aake GT lag jao, it's a wonderful place. I said no boss, wapas nahi jana apne ko, aise public sector life mein nahi jana hai. Agar mujhe Delhi mein rehna hai, to I have to do something around here only. So I decided not to go for any of the government job. I decided in my mind, I'll go for a private health sector job, and that too in Delhi. So after final year, exams, us samay zyada campus year nahi hote the. So I got the one of the company, and other thing what I want to tell you, that I was an introvert person. An introvert person is deciding a career in sales. Okay. So that was another shift. So I got the job, and one of my senior told me that time, ki boss, don't join this company. This company's performance is very poor, and they are going to close. And again, the childish and innocent thought comes in. What is a company? It's a pupil only. We'll go and change the company. If performance is bad, we will improve it. And that was the thought, and landed into that company, and it was fact. They were losing their customers. Their product performance was bad. And good part was that there was my boss was taken, and there were two other guys, youngsters like us. And there was a team of three. We started working and reorganized the entire operations. We went to the old customers, build up their confidence, delivered what we told to them, demonstrated our commitment, improved the market reach, looked at new customers, and the company then from negative sales to turned into the positive sales. So that was the turning around of the organization during that time. And then we introduced a new product, that is the Toshiba technology AC variable voltage elevator. Now, after 3.5 years, I saw an ad. There is a company, an Indian company, one of the top in top 100. That company was there, market leader in hydraulics. And they are coming out with a new product technology, German technology, that is a hydraulic kind of technology elevators for passenger applications. Now, it's the first time in India, that concept. So that fascinated me. And then electrical engineer went to hydraulics engineering. Okay. So I got the job there, single marketing person there, no other person. Other technical people were there in the plant, they were recruited. One leaflet. Now one leaflet, product is not there, only it is on paper. I started moving around. I went around the streets of the Delhi. I went around each and every architect, builder. Wherever I go, first question, where is the product? Then, what's the price? And there is a limitation. You can go up to fourth floor. You cannot go beyond fourth floor in that technology. So up to third floor, there is elevator is not mandatory. So who will buy the product which is the double of the price of the conventional elevator? 6 months I was moving around. Product still not come. It was not manufactured. I probably thought that is the biggest mistake of my life. In the beginning of the career, I have taken a wrong decision. What can I do? There were a couple of people who were basically taking interest in product. So first job was that I have to at least close one or two deals where I can demonstrate to other, yes, I am doing the job there, I am doing the job there. I still remember Jukaso Inn was one of the hotel in Connaught Place. They gave me letter of intent, and still they have not got the product. So that letter of intent, I was using it everywhere. Yeah, I am doing the job there. And then one of the other customer, I went against my boss, whatever price he gave me, I went against him and took the order and closed it. And that's how I started. But again, the question was, will the normal market buy this product with all these questions? So then there was a shift in strategy, change in strategy. This product is not for the normal market. What should I do? I started creating the designer cars, designer elevator, glass elevators, brass kind of things, cage. Okay, that is one. Second is tap all the houses, particularly like Delhi, if anybody knows, New Friends Colony or Greater Kailash and all those areas where the top corporate chiefs are staying. They have ample money, but they may have the old parents, which they may feel that for two floors also they need the elevator. And this elevator you can install in the existing building. So that was the market I looked at. And third was the heritage buildings, old buildings in the area. And that turned around the thing, that strategy, shift in the strategy, and that becomes our market. So there people were able to afford the price, and then product got established, successful. why I am giving you this example, whatever today you talk about startups, so this was the startup basically, and that kind of challenge is there in the startup business. Then at that age, it helped me in learning a lot many things, gave me the full exposure. It helped me in establishing the organization across, product across. So there I grew up to say 8-9 years I worked there, I grew with the organization. But then the question again, what next? Am I becoming a product man? Am I becoming an elevator man? Why should not I try some other industry? So that question came in, and then I started again looking for a change. So there was a multinational company in Cincinnati, Milacron, it's almost 200 years old, and a lot of case studies in Harvard and IIM Ahmedabad, one can go through that. That company was in India. 95 they came, 99 I joined as a regional manager north. Now this electrical engineer again went to the plastic technology. They were manufacturing the plastic machinery, injection molding, blow molding, and I did not know about plastic anything. I only know those polythenes. But plastic, I don't know how many of you may be knowing, it's a very, very vast field. Everything, everywhere there is a plastic. It's all is plastic, okay? All segments, automotive, consumer durables, consumer products, electrical, everywhere there is a plastic. So issue was, the company had hired the people from a company which had a monopoly in the market for years in Indian market. They had the habit of where the consumer come in queue. Consumer come in queue and then they will give in the product. But market was changing. Competition was coming in from China, Taiwan and within the India. So change management was the another thing which was tried out there. Mindset of the people, taking them along, creating lot many systems, procedures. So that's how that company got established, and Delhi, Northern region was the only place, area which could make the company survive. So I was offered double of the promotion and taken to Ahmedabad, their headquarters, for a national and SARC and a CA role. Now, that was the time I never wanted to leave Delhi. That was my design. Now there's an offer. What can you do? The family, discuss with them, supported, kids were small. Lot many emotional pressures, ki why should I disturb them? But took a call, went to Ahmedabad, but decided family will not move. Worked there for 3.5 years. Established the similar thing what was done in North, the other part of the country. And the today that company is one of the market leader. Leader was at my time itself, and then continued till today. Competed with China, Taiwan, everyone, and they are doing well in India. Now what next? I was at the top second position. My age was between 35 to 40. Should I remain at Ahmedabad till 58, 60 years of the age? Can I? I will become CEO. Another couple of years, my CEO will retire. I'll become CEO, I'm number two. But can I remain at Ahmedabad for CEO for another so many years? So again, what next came in my mind, and there was a Delhi power distribution, privatization was taking place. Then I looked at, it is a mass consumer base, it's a retail market, and revenue almost, whatever I was doing, suppose I was doing 500 crore, the revenue is 5,000 crore. So it will give me a lot of other learnings. Got the offer here, came back to Delhi. Delhi, I got the offer within 3 months notice was there, and there was a news flash in the market. Fast meter ke issues ki wajah se, there was a total nuisance in the Delhi market. Political issues were made, and that time I landed in that company. And that company itself, you see the destiny, all are enjoying that power distribution business, you know, any of distribution company, they are the, you know, God. You want an electrical connection, you want a supply. So they have that kind of mindset. But there, I was given an area, Northeast Circle, carved out from East Circle, where the rampant theft, of electricity. Criminal area, I never been to that part of Delhi, that is the northeast Delhi, Dilshad Garden, Nand Nagari, Karawal Nagar. You see the newspaper, you'll see a lot of many things are happening. So big challenge. Started working over there. So here the learning was more on the process side. Process, customer centricity, bringing the people along, and enforcement. So lot many things we worked on, and we bring down the losses. And today that circle is one of the comparable circle with any other circle in Delhi. And then I took over the overall role. Now I was the overall now heading the business till 2016. Then what next? Not much to do. You're coming to the office, going in the evening. Not much of investment taking place because of other reasons, policy reasons in electricity sector. So had an opportunity at Calcutta for CEO, moved to Calcutta. Now here that company, I never knew that it's a 100 years old company. Today, this year is a 100th year, and oldest company in distribution of electricity in Asansol. And one of the lowest T&D losses, any of the electrical engineer may be knowing it, technical and distribution losses, and one of the supply reliability they maintain. But here one of the good opportunities that you are open for renewables, generation or other O&M services, so all kind of businesses we are doing. Now coming to power sector in India is basically under the transformation stage. What I want to share with you that it's a huge basically opportunity. If you look at the per capita consumption still is a 1/3 of the world average. We are at 1100 units and world is at 32 or 3300 units. And if you look at from the developed country point of view, some countries they have got 5000, 10000. So that much of scope is there in India. So we are at 1/3, so that has to go to those levels. So that is one. Second is the distribution losses. We are at 22%, world average is 8%. So most of the government distribution companies, your supply companies, if you see they are in a financial mess, they are not able to revamp the network, or many issues are there. So that is another opportunity. Third, what is happening is disruption. World over, disruption is because of the fossil fuel, getting away from the fossil fuel, everybody is moving to renewable. Now, once you move to renewable, we have also moved on. Now, you need a lot of smart technologies in the system. Now, smart technology, smart meter, smart grid, you have to balance the grid because in solar, you can't have the night power. It is more dependent on the weather. So that kind of balancing is possible in the grid through a smart system only. Then other thing is happening, whole of this industry is moving from centralized generation to distributed generation. Distributed generation means that you can generate the power. You have the rooftop solar and you can generate the power and give it back to the network. So that is the thing coming in. Apart from that, other development in the artificial intelligence, IoTs and smart metering, smart grids and blockchain technologies. So there is enough potential if anybody is pursuing or thinking of making career. So power is an area, it's a big scope. Thank you. Thank you very much.